Welcome to Cost Accounting. This video will cover allocating indirect cost using simple costing and ABC costing. This process is stage 2 of the cost allocation process. Recall that stage 1 would allocate the support cost to the production departments. And these production departments will be our cost pools that we'll be allocating to the cost objects. So each of the cost pools gets distributed to each of the cost objects. The allocation method chosen depends on how managers group overhead cost. Groups of overhead cost are referred to as cost pools, sometimes cost buckets. There are 3 methods of allocating indirect product cost to products. These are all variations of normal costing. The simple method, known as traditional in your managerial class, where a single plant-wide overhead rate is used for the entire factory. A dual cost allocation method, where the separation of indirect cost into 2 pools occurs, one for fixed and one for variable. And finally, activity-based costing, also known as ABC, where multiple overhead rates exist, one for each activity. Simple costing sometimes is known as peanut butter costing, in addition to traditional costing. It gets its name for peanut butter costing as that's supposed to be an easy lunch or an easy snack. And simple costing implies that this approach is easy. It's often acceptable for companies with a limited variety of goods or companies that have very little indirect cost. Activity-based costing is for companies with multiple cost pools or companies that have a need for multiple cost pools. It allocates indirect cost based on what drives the cost. Relatively expensive to implement, but it's a lot more refined, and product costs are more accurate. Let's look more closely at simple costing. We group all the indirect cost of production, known as manufacturing overhead, into one cost pool. The allocations are based on activities that are volume-based, typically direct labor hours, direct labor cost, machine hours, and number of units produced. A company will determine a predetermined overhead rate, sometimes labeled as POHR. The numerator has the estimated overhead, and the denominator the estimated activity. Activities are often known as drivers. When we apply overhead, we take this rate and we multiply it by the actual activity. Under activity-based costing, we separate the indirect cost into multiple cost pools. There are typically 5 to 8 cost pools in an ABC system. The pools are based on activities that drive the cost in each of those pools, rather than the volume-based denominators used with simple costing. This method is primarily used to allocate manufacturing overhead, though some companies use it to allocate support or other common cost. In determining the rates, we use the same type of formula, and we allocate it or apply it in the same manner. However, there will be multiple rates and multiple allocations. The underlying premise is that activities underlie cost. ABC systems typically use a 4-level cost structure, and this helps us determine how far down the production cycle the cost should be allocated. Let's look at these 4 cost driver bases: facility level activities, product level activities, batch level activities, and unit level activities. Facility level activities, the cost pool should consist of the factory cost that impact all of the products produced, not just Coca-Cola, or not just Sprite, but all of the products produced in that facility. It could include depreciation on the factory building, factory insurance, factory supplies, janitors, all of the costs related to the facility. Production level activities are cost for specific products, such as cost for just Coca-Cola Zero and cost for just Sprite. Could include quality control, training employees how to produce products. Batch level activities are specific to particular batches of products, such as setting up a machine, cleaning the machine after each batch, doing maintenance periodically on each machine. And finally, unit level activities are performed every time a product is produced. Some companies actually refer to the direct materials and direct labor as unit level activities. These costs are usually variable, and they correlate to something we do with each individual unit. Machine types of cost are also considered unit level activities. What signals could suggest that a company might benefit from adopting an ABC system? If a company has significant indirect cost, and maybe they're only using one or two cost pools, a company may have most or all of its overhead that's considered to be unit level. A company may have products that consume different amounts of resources. A company may have products that consistently show small profit, though the products should be profit makers. And we may have some disagreements amongst the accounting and the manufacturing and marketing people over what is the real cost of products. To set up an ABC system, a company first determines the cost object. Then the company forms cost pools by grouping the cost of performing a particular activity together. And all costs in a pool should have the same cause. They should not be the same type of cost, but they should exist because of the same activity. We can include items together such as indirect wages, depreciation, supplies, maintenance. Some can be fixed, some can be variable. Next, we select the cost driver that has the cause and effect relationship with the costs that we've put into each pool. The considerations managers think about when selecting a cost driver will be based on their experience, industry practices, and a cost-benefit analysis of each option under consideration. How do we perform ABC? The first step is to calculate the rate for each cost pool. Estimated cost over estimated activity. And remember that this cost on the numerator is only indirect cost. The next step, we multiply each cost pool rate, the rate we calculated in step one, times the actual activity, and that will give us allocated cost. Then we total the allocated cost from step two, and this is the total allocated to whatever product we're trying to determine. Sometimes we call this applied overhead. Finally, we add the allocated cost to the direct cost, and that gives us the total cost of that cost object. If we want a unit cost of that cost object, divide by the number of units produced during the period. Companies must consider capacity when developing an ABC program. The activity, the denominator, can be measured on a practical, actual, capacity basis, or some other estimate. Practical capacity is preferred over the actual capacity because it doesn't hide the cost of the idle capacity within the product cost. It gives us a much more accurate cost of activities used to produce the product. The advantages of ABC include more accurate costing. It helps managers control costs better. It mitigates product cross-subsidization. There are some disadvantages as well. It's very expensive to implement, but once it gets implemented, then it's worth it to go ahead and use it because there's just a little updating each year. There's no separation of fixed or variable costs, so this makes incremental analysis difficult for some companies. Let's look more closely at what happens when we take all the indirect cost and try to allocate them to units equally or on some volume-based activity. This can create undercosting or overcosting. Undercosting occurs when overhead allocated under ABC is greater than if traditional is used. This occurs because a product consumes a high level of resources, but it appears to have a relatively low total cost. Overcosting is allocated under ABC is less than if traditional is used. This creates overcosting. And this occurs when a product consumes a low level of resources, but it's reported to have a relatively high total cost. Some recent trends that affect the choice of an allocation method include the increase in product diversity. As products become more diverse, some use more resources than others. And that means we have to make sure that the costs are allocated accurately to those objects that consume the resources. There's also an increase in indirect cost. Companies have for many years been replacing machines or been replacing workers, which create direct labor, a variable cost, with machines that create a fixed cost. So direct labor can be identified with specific products. Depreciation is an indirect cost and it can't. So that means more costs are being classified as indirect, and more have to be allocated rather than in the several years ago when many costs were direct. There have also been advances in information technology, and this means direct labor is no longer needed. There's competition in foreign markets, so managers must make sure that they reduce cost to stay competitive. There are some issues with implementation. Some companies, in fact many companies, find that once they switch to ABC, that many of their products appear unprofitable. Maybe only 10 or 15% appear to be profitable. So this causes management to alter their product mix by minimizing the unprofitable products. And overall, this causes overall profit to increase. The implementation often mirrors the complexity of the organization. Large companies are likely more complex, so the implementation takes a lot longer and a lot more resources. The complete conversion to ABC requires that a company's external auditors accept the system if it's used for financial reporting. Activity-based management occurs after activity-based costing. You may have heard of the concept of process improvement, which many companies today are engaged in. Activity-based management is a tool in which managers analyze activities. So once the company has determined what causes cost to exist, they can then manage those costs and become more profitable. So the goal is to make the company more efficient and effective by looking at and focusing on the activities, reducing activities, which then reduces the cost. It also serves as the basis for numerous process improvement programs. It helps focus managers' attention on what is most important to create value for companies. This concludes allocating indirect cost, simple costing, and ABC. Thanks for stopping by, and come back again.